I hate this goddamn team. Every time you try to have some shred of hope, they'll find a way to fuck it all up. I've seen this result every single year, yet I'm the dumbass that keeps coming back to them. It's borderline abuse. How many ways can they beat the life out of us? Own goals to clinch a series, offenses going dry, choking in the first round as a President's Trophy winner, quadruple overtime goals against? Notice how I didn't mention a certain event against LA. Fuck that series is dead to me. It's not enough to dwell on the past, because let's be real, Sharks fans are still living in it. We keep thinking to ourselves, don't worry, we may have fallen short again, but they're still in good shape. They've got talent, they've got Doug Wilson, they've got development, they've still got Jumbo Joe, we're good! That was until this year. Now the cold reality of having to pay the piper for years of kicking the can down the road is coming to roost. This is why I hate them. Doug Wilson may be a good GM, but he's been stricken with a debilitating case of Illich syndrome. It's what happens when a team sniffs or gets close to championship glories, but then proceeds to throw all caution into the wind in an effort to chase after it. Sadly, it usually doesn't end well. The Detroit Tigers can let you know of that tale. The problem with Wilson is an issue that many GMs come to deal with when a team is successful. They do everything they can to try and keep the gang together. It sounds nice and is a good story, but you know who doesn't give a shit about sentimentality? Father Time. He is ruthless and gives zero fucks. He only cares about moving forward, be it whether or not a team had their shot or not. San Jose had their chance. They failed. It was less of a showing and more in the style of being tactically spanked. Peter DeBoer never adjusted to the Pens' style of play and paid the price. They had strengths, especially in board play, but they never capitalized on it. The only reason this series didn't end sooner was because Martin Jones played eons over his head. It merely delayed the inevitable. Sharks lose, Pens win the cup, the world hates San Jose, wash, rinse, repeat. That's why you have to make your chances count. If not, you will turn into the Sharks. The last few years have been the standard fare. They have strong regular seasons, yet something always goes awry come playoff time, like always. Sharks are good? Well, here's a white-hot Vegas team that comes from nowhere. People salty that the refs allegedly handed you two straight playoff series wins? Their fans will beat themselves senseless due to what they think is karma. The playoffs are brutal, and as Doug Wilson said, it's like Lucy with the football. Instead of missing, they choke on the air as they're running. It's the worst feeling in the world. Being so close to an achievable goal, yet never getting there. What's the main response of anyone at this point? Throwing everything they can to finally get over the hump. Even if it means long-term sacrifice, the championship makes it all worth it. The band has to be kept together, rewarding the past with security in the future. Doubling down on the core is a dangerous game. On one plane of thought, loyalty. These men led you through thick and thin. So many fan favorites here. Could you imagine Jumbo Joe in a different uniform? Everyone cried when Marlowe left, so you gotta keep him around. He's at least earned that right, hasn't he? The downside? Well, look at these players. Brent Burns, Marc-Edouard Vlasic, Martin Jones, Evander Kane, Logan Couture. A lot of talent in that group, I must admit. But here are the contract lengths they were signed to. And here are the ages of each player when those terms expire. Notice something? Most of them are ending in their mid to late 30s. There's a hidden price to pay to keep the gang around. In this case, it's in paying for their declining years. Brent Burns has never given a shit about the word defense. His value comes in his offensive skill and production. Both are starting to take a nosedive, with both the eye test and analytically. 5 more years of this. With Vlasic, the same thing is happening. Physical skills declining, increasingly unable to keep pace with younger players. Some are even calling his deal one of the worst in hockey. By the way, he has 6 years left on his. Evander Kane is still in his prime, so at the very least his skills won't fall for a few years, but he plays a very physical game. What are the first skills to atrophy? Physical attributes. Pray it doesn't happen in the next 5 years. Martin Jones. This is the first year he's truly been consistent. The bad part is that he's been consistently horrible. A total liability, and Ed has been told to hit the pine more often than not. By the way, you have him for 4 more years. Logan Couture is at least a bright spot, a man who's blossomed into a captain. He started an 8-year contract this season, but he should be fine, as long as the injuries don't get to him. Please. There is one more weapon to go over, though. Eric fucking Carlson. His skating instincts and puck skills are legendary. At least before a severe foot injury nerfed one of his greatest strengths, but he's still really good. Think of what he could do with Vlasic or Brent Burns. Ottawa's selling off everything, so fuck it, it's worth a shot. His year as a Shark was iffy, but it's not like they're going to do something really desperate. God damn it. $11.5 million per year. For 8 years. for a guy who hasn't been anywhere near healthy for the past two seasons. Doug Wilson hasn't just lost the plot, he's been consumed by the Ring of Power. Somewhere I can see him looking to a Palantir and Sauron talks to him and says, "Doug, sign all of your Agent Cordowit your contracts. You're this close to a cup, fuck the future!" Here's the thing, this contract will end up being worth it if you're getting Prime Carlson. There's nothing over the past few years that's shown me that he's going to, if ever, return to his old form. He still has his instincts and puck-moving ability, but his skating is ruined. Look at how he's exposed nowadays. Is this worth $11.5 million a year to you? Hell, I'm a fan of Carlson, and even I can't justify giving him that deal. And wouldn't you guess it, he suffered another long-term injury. This time in a different location. Great. Of course, it was choosing one pill or the other. The cost came in being forced to let go of Joe Pavelski. Say what you will about his declining statistics in Dallas this year, but that man was the heart and soul of this franchise. Look at how the team rallied around him after he was injured in Game 7 against Vegas. You can't replicate that. Carlson doesn't have the tenure here to come close to that impact. Now, I'm not salty that he's no longer the captain. Couture earned the seat with his performance in last year's playoffs, but that loss is felt in the locker room. So now we get to see the Sharks trot out Jumbo Joe and Patrick Marleau for their fourth final tour of duty. Look, I love them as players. They're future Hall of Famers, their jerseys will be hanging from the rafters someday, but they're done. Marleau can at least keep pace, but he's a bottom six forward right now, not a core contributor. Thornton? The guy can barely skate! The knee injuries have taken their toll. I know he says he can play a few more years, but I just can't see it. Here's what you have to understand. I wouldn't be bitching all that much if this season was any good. Would you be shocked to know the alarming reality of this situation? It's not due to any particular player or unit or the stubborn mule known as Peter DeBoer. It's goddamn everything. The only way this core is able to thrive is if it continually brings in fresh talent that somehow emerges as quality depth. The Sharks always did this. Today, that well has run dry. The players they expected to develop haven't done so, and the guys they were counting on have experienced massive regression. Timo Meier, hell of a player last year. Now he's back to his cock-teasing ways. The dude didn't show up for a whole month. Tomas Hertl was great, and now he's gone. A bottom six? What the hell is that? Here's a rotating chorus of young dudes. Please let someone stick. Why are you telling me this defense can't do a damn thing without Radim Simic on it? Really? What about Kevin LeBanc and that ridiculously cheap contract of his? You know the one-year deal grossly underpaying him? He has somehow played down to it. I would be remiss if I said all of these facts weren't the worst thing to happen to the Sharks this past year. You see, in Doug Wilson's relentless descent into managerial illness, draft picks and prospects have become endangered species. Trading for Kane cost them a first-round pick in 2019 after re-signing him the previous year. The Carlson trade had them trading a former first in Josh Norris. Guess what one of the conditions was for re-signing him? Yes, a first-round pick. And it's in an incredibly deep draft with no lottery protections. This was supposed to be a fleecing of Ottawa. Now they may end up getting Lafreniere or Byfield from the pick. Thank God they didn't make the cup final last year or else they'd be giving up another first-round pick. As I said earlier, Father Time does not care if a team was successful or not in their window. No matter what, everyone must pay up. This is looking more and more like the Sharks' time. Even by trying to fire Peter DeBoer in an attempt to spark the team, it's too late. There was only failure. San Jose is looking straight in the barrel that the Kings and Blackhawks did before them. Fortunately for them, those teams won cups. They can at least go to the bottom of the ice rink with hardware in tow. What do the Sharks get? Fuck all. And it may end up costing Doug Wilson his job. Knowing this team's fortunes, he'll get another chance somewhere and lead that team to a cup like the previous GM did for a team further south. I expect nothing less from this goddamn club. Always teasing you with talent, they whisper that this is the year things change. This is the year we get over that damn hump. Sure as hell looks like it, boys. The only thing I wish was that it slowly let me down instead of chucking at me like a live grenade. Could you at least have done it in that way? Not like this. Not like this. We've spent too much goddamn time dealing with this team's bullshit to watch it all fall into the San Andreas fault. What's my motivation for following this team now? To see if Marleau can win a cup with the Penguins? Laugh at Tampa Bay for trading a first for Barclay Goodrow? Pray that everyone somehow turns 5 years younger? Bitch about the coronavirus all you want, but it gave the Sharks their best moment of the year. A mercy killing of this god-awful excuse of a season.